Right, okay. So, I've said on stream that I would be making this video for a very long time now. The video in question is about my two PC setup. I have two computers connected together, which I use to stream with and record locally. And in this video, I will try to explain the entirety of what you need to actually do so. And in this part, I'll be talking about the cable management and all the peripherals you need. Excuse the shit in the background, by the way. So, okay, first of all, you need one computer for gaming. So that's your typical normal computer, the one you use to play games, the one with the graphics card and the PC you're playing with. The thing that's important to note is you actually need a pretty powerful computer as your main computer, because everything you stream depends on how good your main computer is. All the FPS that goes throughout the stream is dependent on the FPS you have on your main computer. So let's say I'm playing WoW at 100 FPS, then the stream will have 100 FPS. Well, it will be downscaled in the streaming program, but if you're under, let's say, 60 or under 30 FPS, then having another computer won't really help you. Of course, it will help take off the load from the main computer, but if you have that kind of FPS when playing normally, then I would suggest upgrading. But more of that in some later parts. I'm going like back and forward here. So, yeah, I have one computer which I game on, and then I have one computer which I stream on. So the specs for the gaming computer will be here, and the specs for the streaming computer will be on this side right now. So you'll note if you're a bit keen on the hardware side of things that the streaming computer does not have a graphics card, and there's a very good reason for that. I'm using XSplit for streaming, and XSplit does not utilize GPU power at all. It's only CPU, which is why I have such a good CPU in my streaming computer. And I'm actually using the integrated GPU of the CPU. So the Intel 4790K actually has a built-in GPU. And you might say, well, aren't those complete shit? Well, yes, they are. You couldn't play WoW with them on like ultra and then high resolution, but you can actually game on them pretty decently. I mean, if you use the computer, like not a laptop, but a stationary computer at school, then that computer most likely had a built-in GPU in the CPU, and that's what you use to watch YouTube with, or browse the web, or play Flash games, or whatever you did on your school computer. And if it worked fine in 2005, then why should it not work fine now? So, if you see streamers out there that has a GPU in their streaming computer, it's a waste. There's absolutely no reason to have a GPU in your streaming computer. There's no reason. I mean, if you have a built-in GPU, then that's more than enough, because the streaming program does not utilize the GPU power at all. So, you have your gaming computer and you have your streaming computer. Now what? Well, you do need a capture card to connect all these things. So, I'm using an AVerMedia Live Gamer HD, which is a built-in capture card. If you're using that on in your streaming computer, which I am, there is actually, well, on your motherboard there's a PCIe lanes, PCI Express. That's the long ones on your bottom left motherboard side, and you also have the short ones, the PCIe 2.0 or 1.0. The Live Gamer HD actually fits in all of those. So even if you only have PCI Express 16 slots, you know, the really long ones for the graphics card, just psh, plop them in the in there and it works. So other than that, I have I can actually move the camera here. Fuck editing, right? Okay. So excuse the mess, first of all. Let me try to get the lighting here so you can actually see something. Yeah, I think that's the best I can do. So, cables. Be prepared to have a lot of cables if you're running a setup like this, especially if you have like three monitors, which I have. So, well, the right computer, that's the streaming computer. And there's so much shit in the background, but don't think about that, please. So, in your this is my streaming computer. If you see there, that's the cable coming from the onboard graphics card that goes into my monitor there. So that's, you know, that's one computer. And then you have from the capture card the GPU cable from this goes into the HDMI splitter in the back here via HDMI. And then out from the HDMI splitter, it goes into my capture card. And then from the capture, that's going into the HDMI in. That's the left one. And then coming out from the right, that goes to my main monitor. So basically, everything that gets recorded on the stream is that monitor, this one. So, if you see here, well, actually, I don't have it connected, but anyway, if you have it connected, then everything that's here shows up on this screen. And you know, that's fine, you know, everything is fine, that's completely understandable, easy to get, but what about the sound? It doesn't work, you know. I spent days figuring this out, and what I had to do is, first of all, the sound does get connected via HDMI from PC1 to PC2, and from PC2 to PC1, so they interchange. So my sound here is connected from well, my headset goes into this audio mixer in the front here, and then in the back it goes from USB to USB, and then the output, the green thing on your 7.1 channel onboard audio thing from your motherboard, that's a 3.5mm audio jack to 3.5mm audio jack to the sound in. And then what that allows you to do, when you open up XSplit, you can see here, it says add. Let's see, add, and then camera, and then AverMedia HD Capture C985 Bus 1. And then when you activate that, you see the screen in the background, like this. And if you go on this computer, let me just switch the mouse, then you have a new setting here. It's called AverMedia HD4. And what that allows you to do, if I can just take my camera back here, what that allows you to do is actually have all the sound coming from your gaming computer, it goes into the streaming computer, and then the sound goes into your headset. So that's basically how it works with connecting the computers together. I'm actually not sure if you actually need the HDMI splitter, because well, at first I thought I had to use the output of the HDMI splitter, but I'm only using the input, and then I have the HDMI coming from the capture card instead, the output to my main computer. So I think that covers most of it. Of course, you need a set of keyboard and a set of mice for the gaming computer. So I can probably show you, the round. So, excuse the shit here. So, this keyboard, this mouse, goes into this computer. And then keyboard, mouse goes into this computer, which also has this monitor. So basically, everything recorded on this screen gets transferred into the computer and then out here to the AV media capture thing. And then, that's how you record both video and sound. So hopefully that should help you a little bit with the streaming thing, because originally I thought it was a lot more harder than what it eventually turned out to be. Oh, also the microphone that needs to go into the streaming computer. So you're recording the voice on the streaming computer, and then also of course you have to have Skype and everything else on your streaming computer so people can actually hear you. But gaming and everything that happens on the main computer and all the sound obviously coming from that just goes into the streaming program. So what I thought I needed to have in addition is this little baby. This is a Yamaha audio mixer, 4-channel, as you can see here. Here. So if I was using this, I would need to upgrade the microphone to a Blue Yeti Pro. They released a new one, so that actually has an XLR port underneath the microphone itself, which allows you to connect to these XLR audio connectors, and then you just turn it on and you record the voice that way. So basically, the cables coming from your gaming computer goes into this one, and then it goes into your streaming computer. But then, of course, you need additional cables. You need a microphone with an XLR connection. Otherwise, you need an XLR bridge to do so. Sorry, but I found out you don't need to have this at all. So, yeah, I also seen some streamers who use a Scarlett something. Sound card, external sound card. Don't remember the name of it, but it's a little red box, and you don't need that either. So, basically, to summarize everything, you need an HDMI from your gaming computer into your HDMI splitter, and then the cable from the HDMI splitter goes into the AV media capture card on the input. And then the output HDMI goes into your gaming middle monitor, the one you're playing on. And as far as sound goes, you have a 3.5 mm audio jack coming from your gaming computer into your streaming computer on the input of the capture card. And that's basically it. When you start XSplit, and then you add the camera, and then you add the AV media thing, it should work pretty much. I was so amazed that it actually worked. So maybe I'll include that footage. Maybe not. It's in Norwegian, so yeah, I'll probably not do it. But I was so taken aback that I did not have to use the Scarlett audio mixer, and I didn't have to shell out a lot of money on this thing. I mean, this is from work. I was just borrowing it to test out the streaming thing, but not only is it really expensive and you need a lot of extra cables for it, it also is complicated as balls. I don't know how to use this as at all, and I didn't have to use any of that, and I'm really happy basically. So, that's how I did it. Hopefully it works for you. If it did not, then please leave a comment and I'll be sure to help you as much as I can. Hopefully this video was helpful. I'm not really good at, vocalizing, using the English language and relaying a message, but hopefully it worked for you. It worked for me, and this was the easiest, fastest, cheapest method to do so, and I hope it works for you. The only thing you have to think about, which is important, when you get your streaming computer with the OS, whatever that might be, make sure to get Ethernet drivers so you can actually access the internet. That's very important. You need onboard audio. You need the disk management drivers, and you need to download the GPU drivers for your CPU, and you need to download Southbridge CPU chipset drivers and Northbridge chipset drivers, which is kind of a shit to actually get a hold of what kind of drivers you need, because you need the number of the CPU, which can be really difficult to find. So it took me like 2 whole days just downloading drivers, like, oh fuck, this didn't work, okay, the next one, oh fuck, that didn't work, not compatible with your system, okay, fuck you, downloaded a bunch of shit extra programs, because, you know, people who make programs apparently include a lot of shit you don't need. So just, you know, think about that, that it's an extra computer, and you have to take care of it like it's an extra computer. So just bear that in mind. So yeah, hopefully this video was helpful for you, and if not, then I'm very sorry, but please leave a comment and explain what the problem is, and I'll try my best to actually help you. And then coming up in the second part is actually choosing what kind of hardware you want in your streaming computer and the gaming computer. And that's pretty much it. You don't really need a lot of extra equipment. I'm using a audio mixer, but I don't think you need that. I'm using a HDMI splitter. You can get one for 20 bucks or 30 bucks. Just make sure to get one that doesn't distort the video quality, because you don't want that, of course. You want to stream with full HD and the best possible quality you can. That's why you bought the streaming computer in the first place, one would assume. And yeah, HDMI splitter, AVerMedia Live Capture, HD capture card, and then yeah, 3.5mm audio jack to 3.5mm audio jack. Make sure to actually get enough HDMI cables as well. And that's pretty much it. Thank you guys for watching, and please make sure to check out my stream at twitch.tv/romis006. I hope you learned something from this video, and have a good one.